Hi, I'm Agent Bennet, and I'm going to show you how to set up two-factor authentication. Two-factor authentication can keep your accounts and devices safer, even if someone manages to get your password, because you have to enter a second piece of information, often only available through another account or device. That's why it's called two-factor. The first factor is often the password. The second is often a security code that's sent to a separate device or account. So, if an unauthorized person was attempting to access your device or account, they would need both. This adds an additional layer of security, and it's pretty easy to set up. Along with two-factor authentication, there are other important steps you can take to increase security. One of the main ones is simply getting to know your devices by reading through the manuals or getting familiar with the options and functionality within the app or website. Getting more information on how your device works will help you understand if there are any risks associated with it. In this video, I'll be setting this up on my Ring account. I'll show you how to do this through a smartphone app and also how to do it on your computer. Even though I'm using Ring to show you the process, two-factor authentication is available for many other devices, apps, and services. So make sure you check yours. All right, let's start with the smartphone. I'll be using my Samsung Galaxy S20 FE 5G and the Ring app, which I've already downloaded onto my phone. Depending on what device you're using, and as this app updates, these steps might be slightly different. Tap the menu icon on the top left corner, under Account Security, choose Two-Step Verification. Your Ring account defaults to using an email address, but for this demo, I'm going to select Get Codes by Text Message. Go ahead and read through the information here, and then tap Continue. Now enter your Ring password, under the email address associated with your account, and hit Continue. Enter the phone number that you'd like Ring to send a code to anytime a password is required, and then hit Continue. At this point, Ring will send that phone number a text message with a special code. When you receive the message, type in the code and tap Verify. You should see a success screen if you entered the code correctly. And you'll also see part of the phone number that codes will be sent to in the future. Tap Got It, and you're all set up. I'll also show you how to do this from your computer, but while I've got the app open on my phone, I wanted to give you a little tour of the control center, where you can find other security settings and information for all your Ring devices. Account verification is where you can create codes for authorizing a new device, or codes you can use when working with Ring customer support. If you tap Authorized Client Devices, you'll see a list of devices that can access your Ring account. If you see anything that shouldn't be there, you can just tap the trash can next to the device name and it will no longer have access. Video encryption has some basic information about how video is encrypted or securely stored within Ring. And if you tap on Advanced Settings and then End-to-End Encryption, you'll see an option for adding another layer of security for your videos, so only you can access this content. All right, I promised I'd show you how to set up the same two-factor authentication from your computer, and it's just as simple. Just log into your Ring account on ring.com. Go to the dashboard and hover your mouse over Account. Click Manage Account. Go to the Two-Step Verification section and click Manage. Then click Get Codes by Text Message. If you like, read through the information and then click Continue. Now enter your Ring password under the email address associated with your account and click Continue. Enter the phone number that Ring can send a code to anytime a password is required, and then click Continue. A text message will now be sent with a code to the phone number you entered. Once you receive this code, enter it and then click Verify. Again, you should see a success screen if you put in the code correctly, and it will display a portion of the phone number that codes will be sent to in the future. Click Back to Account and congratulations, you're all set up. Again, two-factor authentication is an important step in maintaining security across your apps and devices. It's a good idea to check with our other smart products apps to see if two-factor authentication is available. Like I said before, along with two-factor authentication, another great security measure is to get really familiar with your devices and settings. Here's another tip. never share your account information with others. If you do need to share your Ring camera with someone else, like a neighbor watching for a package while you're gone, there's a better way. We actually have a tech tips video on that topic that shows you how to do this. Check it out in the notes below. That way, you're not giving out sensitive account info or passwords. Speaking of, don't use the default or predictable passwords. Instead, use your own unique passwords. Again, we have another great tech tips video on that topic as well. The link is below. If you take these important steps, they'll do wonders for keeping your accounts and your home more secure. Hopefully this video was helpful. If it was, give it a like. If you have questions, leave them in the comments. And be sure to subscribe to our channel for more tech tips from Best Buy. Thanks for watching!